What's going on, guys? It's your boy Adjen Bagen for another Outer Plane video. And for today, we've got the official leak for the upcoming 3-star character. And my, oh my, I don't know what to say about the design of this character. Well, let us go ahead and check this one out. This is coming from the official Outer Plane Twitter post. I cannot show the link because Twitter is not activated here in my PC. On my phone, but I've got the image here from the Discord server, the official the Outer Plane Discord server. We have here the new upcoming 3-star Behold Diane, the Hammer Princess or Hammer Queen or something like that. Because if you will notice that she has a crown, right? So she's probably a saintess, a princess, or a queen that likes to hammer down every obstacle along her way. And man, this one is she has a massive hammer. Yeah, you know what I'm about to say. If you know, you know. Yes, she has a massive hammer. She kind of looks like Rowana from Epic 7. Yeah, she gives me Rowana vibes from Epic 7. Maybe they have some inspiration from that one, because Rowana is also very lewd in Epic 7. And there are a bunch of different reactions when she was first teased in Epic 7. And here, maybe people are happy with this one. Some people are not really happy with the direction that the game is taking. I don't really like Outer Plane to have this kind of identity where they are something like Azur Lane territory. You know what I mean? Like, you know what Azur Lane? When people talks about Azur Lane, you know what they are talking about. And I don't like that we are going into that kind of direction with these new upcoming characters. Edelweiss is a pretty darn good, pretty good design, but this one is just pretty much pure fan service. It feels like they want to drain your wallets, because people will pull for this kind of thing. There are players who are pretty much into this kind of thing. They probably know their target audience when releasing this kind of character design. But design wise, it looks good, but it's too much fan service in my honest opinion. But thick thighs saves lives. I'm more of a legs enjoyer than a booba lover, but booba sells. That's the hard truth about gacha games, not only in Outer Play but in every gacha games out there. Booba sells. Let us now talk about what will be her upcoming class and element. And since she has this greenish hair, it's not really green but something like a more greenish, she's probably going to be earth, right? And she has a hammer, and usually classes that has a hammer are usually called bruisers. She's probably leaning towards a tank route. That's my wild guess for her. I don't have the leaks, the unverified leaks. I don't do that one. This is just my wild guess and pure speculation only, so just take it with a big grain of salt. So that is my wild guess for her. Regarding her kit, she's probably going to be a bruiser, since we are in the bruiser stage of the game, where the game is releasing more and more bruisers. We've got Demidrakan, we've got Edelweiss, we've got Kanon, which is probably one of the best bruisers in the game. And probably Diane will also probably be going to be a bruiser. Since you've already gotten the past few characters to be fire and water, she's probably going to be earth. So that is why I think she's going to be earth defender class, something like a bruiser. I just hope that if she has some form of damage scaling, it should have been a true damage scaling, not something like the case for Edelweiss, which is trash. So yeah, I'm really not prepared for this kind of new 3-star character to be added into the game. The day feels very fast because it seems to me like we've just gotten Edelweiss the past few days. And now we are already teased with the new upcoming 3-star, and I did not realize that we are already two weeks already since Edelweiss was launched. My resources are pretty much not ready for her. I'm just gonna be hoping that with my 57 summons, I hope that in these resources I will be able to pull her. Nonetheless, I'm still gonna be pulling for her because I am a content creator. I do contents about new characters, reviews about them, and yeah, I hope that I will be able to pull her with my limited amount of resources. What about you guys? Are you pulling for Diane? Just looking about her, just if you're going to be deciding just based on design alone, is she a must pull or not? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. And I think that's it for me for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please leave a like and subscribe. I would really appreciate it if you could help me grow my channel more. And thank you to everyone who are supporting my channel. I appreciate every one of you. Until next time, peace.